Hey everybody, we're just here to give you all an update about what's been going on with our family. So ever since the war broke out, Tali and I have been just really seeking God on how we can be a voice and speak out about what's happening in Israel. So as many of you know, my family is there with Hayabel, and they're on the ground helping people in this and everything that's going on. And so we've just been reaching out to churches and speaking at places. We actually were able to join a rally up in St. Louis for Israel. So that was a blessing. So yeah, it's been good.
Yeah, we're surrounded here. Our community loves Israel, supports Israel. And you know, I think when it first happened, Brayden and I were both kind of in shock of kind of, you know, just not knowing what to do and just kind of staring at each other like, we just want to go over there to help. What are we going to do? And but then a couple days, we were just like, okay, we need to do something. We're here now. What can we do? And so that's when Brayden just started calling all the pastors, you know, connected to a lot of local pastors here. And everyone's attention is on Israel right now. And so it's a really neat season to take advantage of because people are wanting to hear and their people are wanting to know more about the situation. And so I think it's a really good opportunity for us to go and be like, this is something that is on the heart of God. It's something that needs to be on our hearts. And so, yeah, so as a local community, I think we've shared with about six congregations. We had one of the guys here went out and shared at a local church. We've also gone up and we went up to a rally in the community. And I think we had about 30 people from our community go up. And it was a really neat thing because we got to just share with the Jewish community. We were like, we came from 2.5 hours away just to stand with you and tell you that we support you and we love you. And they were pretty emotional just hearing our hearts and feeling supported and loved from the Christian community. And and then one of our families here also did another rally in a local city. And it was a pretty neat thing because they just randomly scheduled this rally, not knowing that directly after that rally, a Free Palestine rally was happening, and which thankfully only two people came to. but they were able to be there and show their support. And then they were also given the opportunity to even talk with these people that had come out on the other side. It's been a really neat season. I feel like for us, we've kind of put aside most of our plans that we were kind of thinking of doing in this season to really grab a hold of this opportunity that we have right now. And so what we're encouraging local churches to do is to really pray for Israel, to get educated about what's going on in Israel, and then to give. Those are the three things that we're really encouraging the local Christian community to do and standing in support of the Jewish people in Israel. Do you want to talk about the 21-day fast?
Yeah, so back in May, there was a 21-day fast. It was called the Isaiah 62 fast, which speaks of God raising up watchmen on the walls of Jerusalem that will not hold their peace day or night until he makes Jerusalem a praise. And so that was a great awareness-building thing for the global body, just to begin to think about, hey, yes, we need to be praying for Jerusalem, praying for Israel. And so right now, if you're interested in, you know, plugging into more about what's going on the prayer front, the ICEJ, this is the International Christian Embassy in Jerusalem, is putting together what they're calling Targeted Esther Fast, Targeted Strikes, they're calling it. But you can go to Global Esther Fast and you'll get the information on that. But they're just encouraging people to take on 3-day fasts, you know, just intermittently over the next couple weeks, because it looks like this war is going to be going on over the next couple weeks, 3 or 4 weeks possibly. And so that's our encouragement to you, to engage as much as you can spiritually. You know, in Esther's time, she realized this was a spiritual battle. And so, you know, what's happening is nothing new. There's always been Haman's, Yasser Arafat's, different ones, Hitler's, that have come up through history. They had this obsession with the destruction of the Jewish people. And so it's really nothing new. But Esther had the discernment to understand this is a spiritual battle. And so she said, gather, you know, everyone together, fast and pray for me. I'm going to go to the king to try to, you know, try to turn this evil edict that Haman had given to destroy the Jewish people, to go gather everyone together, fast and pray for 3 days, that I'll have favor before the king. And so what the ICEJ is doing right now, I think, is critical, because we're engaging in this battle from a spiritual standpoint, understanding that this is a very much of a spiritual battle we can engage in, fasting and prayer. The other thing I want to mention is my family, they're on the ground, they're doing a fundraiser called Operation Itai. If you go to the Israel Guys, you can find out more on that. I encourage you to follow the Israel Guys. They're giving you, you know, on the ground information about what's going on. But they are doing this fundraiser to raise funds to help out with the local farmers right around them. A lot of them are in a vulnerable spot right now because a lot of the reservists, the Army, the IDF are out on the front lines, and so it's leaving these communities in a vulnerable spot. So they need basic security equipment. So this is an opportunity for us to be involved, and we encourage that.
Yeah, I think that it's just important to understand how Israel is like one of the biggest testimonies of God's faithfulness. Like the fact that Israel is there today, that the Jewish people have returned, it's the biggest testimony that the Bible is true, that God is real, that He is faithful to keep His promises. And so us as Christians, we need to get behind that. And and get educated. There's so much information out there in the media that is, number one, spreading false things, but they're definitely not spreading biblically grounded, perspectives on how to look at the situation. And that's something that us as Christians, we need to understand. We have to understand that the freedom and salvation of Palestine comes by the salvation of all of Israel, which is what God has said in His Word. And so we really need to get behind the Jewish people as they are standing by these words, by these promises that God made to him.
Yeah, I want to mention too, just an encouraging story. So my brother, Mac Tanner, was actually called up to go help one of these hilltop communities, he and a friend of his. So they get out there and they're just doing a night watch of the night. They didn't have any weapons, all they had was a flashlight, bulletproof vest. But they overlooked this valley, and down in this valley they saw this massive angel. And Mac Tanner's friend, he actually yelled out to the angel, said, "I'm so glad you're here." They needed this angelic help. And so it's important for us to remember that in the intensity of all that's going on, to not fear. You know, Elisha, when he was surrounded by these enemies of Israel, he's praying for his servant. He said, "God, open my servant's eyes so he can see." And in his servant's eyes, he sees all these chariots of fire around the mountaintops. And in this story, Elisha is saying there's more of us than there are of them. And so when we get those spiritual lenses, get that spiritual perspective that, yes, there's actually far more heavenly host defending Israel than there are enemy armies. So it's important to remind ourselves of that and to, yes, pray. And as we pray, we see this with Daniel. Daniel prays, and then there's angelic activity released. And so we believe that our prayers are not just, we're not just praying just, because that's the only thing we can do. We're praying because prayer, as the scripture says, is mighty. The weapons of our warfare are mighty for the pulling down of strongholds. So we encourage you as a family, as a community, engage in prayer. Talk to your pastors that you know, talk to people and ask them, you know, let's have a night of prayer for Israel. Corrie Ten Boom, her grandfather started praying for the peace of Jerusalem 100 years before everything that went on with her saving the Jewish people in her home. And so it's important for us to engage with this battle in a spiritual, from a spiritual standpoint, and realize that praying for the peace of Jerusalem is so critical right now. So we really encourage you to do that. And thank you for watching this, and may you be blessed.